By 260,000 years ago, the Homo heidelbergensis populations in Africa, from Jebel Erhad in the north, as far as Florisbad in the south, had evolved into the Homo sapiens, better known as humans. Like their ancestors, they lived in groups and communicated through sounds and gestures. But they were able to speak at a much higher level, as they had the capacity for articulate speech and produced a large range of speech sounds. And they were narrow-chested, had a graceful build, and were a bit smaller than their forerunners, with adults reaching only 152 to 168 centimeters, 5 to 5.5 feet in height. Like their ancestors, they were foraging for wild edible plants and aquatic resources, like fish and shellfish. They made spears for hunting, some also hafted with stone spear tips. They hunted together, not only big game, but also smaller animals. They crafted hides from animal skins. They made fire to cook food and stay warm, made engravings on pebbles, and used pigments such as ochre. They still used caves wherever possible, as they offered better shelter. But they also made bone tools, and the large Acheulean cutting stone tools were gradually displaced by Levallois prepared core technologies. After 60,000 years, hominins slept on grass beddings made of insect-repellent plants. Another 15,000 years later, Homo sapiens arrived at the Mislia cave in Israel, outside Africa. Within 15,000 years, clothes became widely used by humans, who will no longer be confined to the warm climate of Africa. They protected the body from cold, heat, sunlight, the elements, rough surfaces, rash-causing plants, and insect bites. Forty thousand years later, Homo sapiens reached Aunjugu in the western Sahelian zone. Soon, the Sangoan manufacturing style developed from the earlier Acheulean types. In addition to the stone tools, bone and antler picks were also used, especially for grubbing. In the meantime, the San human hunter-gatherers who manufactured Sangoan tools expanded to southern Africa. Soon, the Pygmies humans expanded to Central African forests and made Sangoan stone and bone tools. In the meantime, early Homo sapiens from Mauritania to Adjarbous in Niger up to the Nile Valley used the Levallois technique to make Aterian stone tools. 5,000 years later, hafting was widespread. Scrapers, knives, and points all were hafted, and a wide range of activities were facilitated. Also, the diet of early humans included seafood obtained by beachcombing, creating shell middens in Eritrea. Soon, humans crossed the Bab el-Mandeb Strait in the Arabian Peninsula, settling in Jebel Faya. 25,000 years later, beads were made at Skul Cave by Homo sapiens from Nassarius sea snail shells. At the same time, vocal languages have begun diversifying. Soon, humans used containers found in nature, such as hollow pumpkin-like fruits, for storing food, to carry it more easily, and also to protect it from other animals. In the meantime, hunter-gatherers near Wadi Halfa on the Nile slept in dome-like shelters of skins or brush. After 8,000 years, the people who reached the Kafsa cave through the Nile Valley practiced ceremonial funerary rites and buried the dead in the cave's floor. The deceased was placed in a rectangular grave carved out of the bedrock. They also placed deer horns as an offering, and ochre was used for body dyeing and ornamentation. Within 2,000 years, in the Katanda region, Pygmies humans made Semliki harpoons to spear catfishes. Another 17,000 years later, some humans started to wear shoes. 3,000 years later, ancestral Eurasians diverged from other African populations. They left East Africa, reaching Arabia via the Bab el-Mandeb Strait, starting the Great Coastal Migration. After around 22,000 years, bows and arrows became widely used by humans from the Sibudu Cave in South Africa to the Fahian Lena Cave in Sri Lanka. Sometimes they also used poisons on arrowheads. It will soon become the primary hunting method for thousands of years. Six thousand years later, Near Eastern people arrived in North Africa. Cormusans developed tools not only from stone and animal bones, but also from hematite. After around 19,000 years, the Mekta Afalu of West Eurasian descent made Ibero-Maurusian tools with backed stone bladelets. Three thousand years later, the once green Sahara is now drying out. Forced by the ever-spreading deserts, the Aterian foragers migrated to the tropics and to the coast. Within 5,000 years, during the excessively dry Ogolian period, the number of settlements made by the Middle Stone Age West Africans decreased. After around 1,000 years, human activity in the Sahara and Arabia stopped as the climate became extremely dry, lakes and swamps dried out, and rivers were stunted. Some 2,000 years later, humans in southern and eastern Africa made Magoshian stone tools, which included microliths and small blades. Soon, microlith using West Africans migrated into and dwelt in Unjugu, alongside earlier residing humans. After 4,000 years, West African hunter-gatherers migrated toward the north, as far as the Sahel boundary. All early humans are, by now, replaced by their descendants. Thank you for traveling back in time with us on this historical journey. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, leave a comment, and select all notifications for more videos like this one. Until next time, keep exploring the past to understand the present, and even foresee the future.